Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to get started with the React Linear Gauge component. React Linear Gauge is used to visualize numeric measurements on a horizontal or vertical scale. Look at this example, the React Linear Gauge is displayed with elements like axis line, pointer, labels, and ticks. In this video, you will see how to add the React Linear Gauge component to an app. Also, you will see how to change the axis pointer value, set custom height and width to the axis line, and add multiple ranges to the axis. Before proceeding, ensure you have installed the latest versions of Node.js and React. I'll be using Visual Studio Code as my editor and showing the output in the Chrome browser. First, I'll open Visual Studio Code, create a new application using the npx create React app command, and name it My React App. Since I want to create the app with TypeScript, I add the template TypeScript. It will take a few seconds to create the project. I navigate to the newly created React app. To use the linear gauge component, I type the npm install at syncfusion / ej to React Linear Gauge --- save command. Now, the package will be installed. Before using a Syncfusion component, it is mandatory to register the trial license key. I open the index.tsx file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. To generate a trial key, refer to the link in the description below. To add the Syncfusion React Linear Gauge component, I open the app.tsx file and remove the default code snippets. Then, import the Linear Gauge component from the Syncfusion EJ2 React Linear Gauge package and add the Linear Gauge component tag. Now save the changes and run the application using the npm start command. Here, you can see the linear gauge displayed with elements like axis line, pointer, labels, and ticks. By default, the axis line height is based on the base element's height, and the default width is 2 pixels. You can set custom height and width using the height and width properties. I add the axis directive tag, which can contain n number of axis directive definitions. Since the gauge holds a single axis, I will add a single axis directive tag. To use the axis directive and axis directive tags, I need to import it from the Syncfusion Linear Gauge package. Then to customize the axis line height and width, I define the line property. Set the height and width properties to 350 and 7 pixels, respectively. I also set the color property to an appropriate value. See now, the axis line is displayed with custom height and width and is in blue. Here, the default pointer value is 0. If I want to change the pointer value to 80, I need to add the pointer's directive tag, which can contain n number of pointer directive definitions. Since this linear gauge holds a single pointer element, let me add a single pointer directive tag. To use the pointer's directive and pointer directive tags, I need to import it from the Syncfusion Linear Gauge package. Then, I set the value property to 80. See now, the pointer value is 80. Next, to set ranges for the axes, I add a ranges directive tag, which can contain n number of range directive definitions. First, I will show you how to add a single range to this linear gauge. I add a single range directive tag within this ranges directive tag and set the start property to 30 and the end property to 60. To use the ranges directive and range directive tags, I need to import it from the Syncfusion Linear Gauge package. Looking here, the range is 30 and 60 on the axis scale. Now, I will show you how to add multiple ranges to a linear gauge and display them in different colors. To do that, I add one more range directive tag within the ranges directive tag. I want to set the range from 60 to 90, so let me set the start property to 60 and the end property to 90. Then, I set the color property to an appropriate value. Look, the newly added range 60 to 90 is in green. Look at the labels here, which display numeric values by default. To display custom labels, let me demonstrate by defining the label style property. I set the format property to a customized value with an additional suffix, degrees Celsius. Here, the value represents the data label. Now, you can see the linear gauge labels displaying the values in degrees Celsius format. In this video, I have shown you how to add the linear gauge component to a React application. I have also shown you how to change the axis pointer value, set custom height and width to the axis line, and add multiple ranges to the axis. If you want to see a working example of this, download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also shared a link to learn about obtaining a free license key to use our React suite if you are eligible for our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please like and subscribe to our channel.